Just before we get started on today's video, folks, I am doing a little bit of a giveaway. Courtesy of Frontier, they sent me 5 keys for the Arctic Pack for Planet Zoo. So if you've got Planet Zoo on Steam and you want to get hold of the Arctic Pack DLC for free, I've got 5 keys to give away. That'll add you the new animals, the doll sheep, the Arctic wolf, the polar bear, and the reindeer, 4 brand new animals, along with something like 250 building pieces, and of course, new rocks and stuff like that as well. Just lots of really cool stuff. And of course, the 2 campaign missions that we'll be playing through today as well. So in order to win, all I want from you, I'm going to do a little competition giveaway kind of thing, and I'll announce the winners in the next video, which will be the final video for our Arctic Adventures campaign. I have to spitball a competition idea off the top of my head. All I want to do is, in the comments down below, let me know which, if you were going to do another pack like the Arctic pack, which pack would you do? You know, it would have to have building themes, it would have to have rocks and stuff, it would have to have nature, and also 3, 4, 5, maximum of 5 animals. Let me know what your dream Planet Zoo DLC would be in the comments down below. I will pick 5 winners, 5 blimmin' winners, before the next video, and I'll announce that in the next video. So, I'll see you then, and enjoy the video. Yeah. Woo! Ooh. Evening, folks, this is Best in Slot, and welcome back to the Planet Zoo Arctic Adventures campaign. In the last video, we added ourselves our very first tundra exhibit, this whole new area in the tundra zone, and over here we have our reindeer. They're currently all diseased, which is fun for the whole family. I'm not really sure what's going on there. That's gone a little bit crazy. Good stuff. So, yeah, that's a good start. So today we're just going to carry on working on our silver. We need 2 more tundra biome animals now. I think the plan is still to move the reindeer from here over into the doll sheep exhibit, and that way we can sort of double up on that one. But just for now, just for this video, we're just going to pick another tundra animal and hopefully get a exhibit going. So, what lives in the tundra? I don't believe we've got any crossover between our animals. Polar bear, it can't be. I think we were who's in a box? Silly elephant. Nobody. Game, stop shouting at me. I think we were leaning towards the Arctic wolf. Yeah? Yeah, sounds like a plan. Some lovely Arctic wolves. Anything else we would possibly want? No, Arctic wolf is what we're going to roll with. So, that's all we're going to do today. We're going to build ourselves an Arctic wolf habitat. Hopefully. That's the idea. We'll see what happens. How thick are you? Are you a 7? You're a big chunky 7? You're a big chunky 7. So, I want to... How's that only one length? It's bloody huge. Okay. Not really sure what I'm doing. We're just gonna roll with it. I want to bring that up, back down again. I'm not sure we're actually going over there, but I know I wanted the bridge, so we may as well stick that in. And we can have the wolves sitting in here. What is going on? All right, that's fine. It doesn't look fine, but it is. If I just pretend it's fine. What are they queuing up for? The workshop. Really? Alright, let's get some tetanus researched. What's going on over here? Yeah, I suppose that makes sense. I do have a lot of people researching multiple things. I just really want to get Arctic level 1, though. About to inbreed. Not a... Hey, no, no. Stop inbreeding. There'll be no inbreeding in my park. Okay, so, this is the tundra zone. You walk forward. We're going to do polar bears. I think what we might do is have the wolves basically... Go away. Basically being next to this exhibit. So you'll walk over the bridge, and on one side you'll look over into the reindeer, and on the other side you'll look over into the Arctic wolves. That sounds like a plan. So let's build this whole shebang. We'll build it in null to kick things off, and then we'll leave a little gap here because you're going to want to walk over here to get to the polar bear and stuff. So we'll kick it off from about there. I'm just going to pretend everything's fine. And we'll have to go back and check in a second. I guess. It's just things go wrong constantly. I think if you actually worried too much about every little problem, you'd never get anywhere. You really wouldn't. It's just, there's always something going cripplingly awful. It's part of the fun. Yeah, we're not going to go too far on this one. The reindeer exhibit is... it's a decent size. I mean, for the Arctic, the wolves, right? The packs, they're going to move around. I think they're allowed, like, a decent sized habitat. I don't see why not. Are we in the ground? Oh, yes, we're very much inside the ground. Again, we're going to go for a long one because we are using the river. Something like that. And we'll put, like, a bridge across there and stuff like that. It's gonna be cool. There we go. That will be our Arctic wolf habitat. What is going on? Right, that's fine. They're all low welfare and stress and stuff like that, but it's always stress, and that always fades pretty quickly. So I'm not really going to worry about that. It sounds a bit mean, I'll admit, but what are you going to do? Oh, yeah, buddy. If you're not in your ideal temperature, just move into your ideal temperature. Oh, right, tell you what, I'm tired of hearing about this. So, we're going to grab ourselves a cooler. Welcome to the cool side of the exhibit. And we're just going to make sure all of it... who needs to save money for electricity and such? Let's just squander it all. There we go. Bloody Nora. That might actually negatively affect some other animals as well, but we'll see. What's my other problem? Ah, yes, we needed to research more than everything else. This power. I'm gonna put only power on research because we need that to. We're gonna need that by the end to finish off the whole thing. Anyways, back to my tundra zone. So, if I just click randomly, that's not gonna work. Let's grab this, grab all this, and turn this into wood. Okay, good stuff. Why didn't that work? Let's find out. Okay. Is it you? What are you obstructed? I'm just... right, yeah. Why is that? Okay. Tell you what, we'll just do what we can, and then we'll go through and fix those little... it's fine! Little terrible problems every now and again. Never hurt anyone. There we go. Nice bit of wood there. Ladies. Gentlemen, as well, I guess. Whoever wants a bit of wood. Who doesn't want a bit of... what is going on? Apparently that's my wood limit. I think it is just too close to the path. So we're gonna get rid of all of that. And we're gonna try again. What I should really do is use something that isn't null barrier but has a curve to it. So we're gonna use the brick instead. Because null barrier will go absolutely anywhere. It just won't necessarily let you change into something else. But if we go from brick to wood, we should be able to kind of like guarantee it's going to work, essentially. There we go. Okay, going to be cool. This is a bizarre exhibit shape. That's way too small, isn't it? That's way too small. Like, I'm down for the exhibit to be a little bit smaller than the reindeer, because it is, you know. I don't know, I just feel like wolves would be fine in a smaller habitat than the reindeer, but that's a teeny tiny ass little exhibit right there. How are we feeling about that? That's better. I'm going to scoot around this bit a little bit. We'll probably have to get rid of some of the water. But just... oh my god. They're trying to mix things up in terms of the general shape as well. Just keeping things interesting. Important in both your marriage and in Planet Zoo. So pull that back to wood. Right. That is plenty. So I'm going to swap over here... back to this stuff. There you go. That's pretty cool. Well, it will be pretty cool. It's not cool yet, but it will be. Bring that down. See a little viewing area. There we go. People are gonna love it. They are blimmin' love it. I think we can bring the whole thing down a little bit. That's probably too high. Not convinced about that. We'll have to wait and see. Let's bring some of these up a little bit. Oopsie daisy. It'd be nice if you could kind of just grab all of it and kind of just set it, you know, from the start. That'd be nice. But does that make any sense? Oh, God, who knows. Okay, cool. The theme has continued. Love me a theme. Love a good theme. I'm pretty okay with this, I think, actually. Got a lot of work to do, still, of course. Don't we always, but I have severe hiccups, which is fun for the whole family. I'll just keep it like that for now, and we're going to move down here probably in the next video for the polar bears or whatever, and that's when we'll worry about the viewing area on that side. Yeah. Maybe I'm going to do that again. As in, what we're going to do instead is turn this into glass. And now we have to do this again. This isn't the most fun... Oh, no. It's not the most fun part. But we do have to do this every single time. The thematic-ness is important. Gotta make it sexy, folks. You've gotta make it sexy. So, again, because I love you all so much. I'm just this wonderful, kind, giving, humble person. I'll skip forward a little bit. Okie dokie, that'll do. I grabbed that once again. We're gonna just keep that as a fairly continuous theme. I might even join them together somehow. But I have sunk this one lower to the ground just for no particular reason. I think just to keep things mixed up a little bit. I think having this one sunk down, it creates a completely different feeling already than the a little bit more open one we have over here with the reindeer. Really, I'm just trying to keep things interesting. So, that's actually pretty done in terms of the viewing and everything. Can we bring... I just want to get this nice and level, and it's like... Oh, surprisingly weirdly difficult thing to do. You need to come up. Alright, I'll do. See, I've got a nice little viewing area over there. Oh, look, he jumped on the rock. Do it again. It's gonna do it. I'm excited. Come on, buddy. I'll give you another one. Give you a bit of help. Yeah, that didn't help at all. Eh? There you go. Nope. Come on. Oh, I think we're about to get a jump over. Santa's reindeer could fly. I don't think you've got much of an excuse here, pal. To be stranded on the rock. How did you get here in the first place? There you go. Just gonna plop in there, aren't you? Okay, apparently tickets are still under, but I find it hard to believe. I'm gonna stick at 24. We'll see if they keep complaining about it. I'm suspicious about that, to say the least. What I'm gonna do is grab this, actually, and just split that off into its own thing. I wanna sink it down just a little bit more. I've just realised that half of it's outside the exhibit. Is that a problem? Oh god, and that these haven't sunk. Okay, there's lots of problems here. Let's go back, let's grab it again. Ah, right. I've made a small mistake. Let's try that again. Let's grab all that. Lovely stuff. There we go. It's fine. Oh no, that's not fine right there though. Okay. Now, I did just have a male hyena grow up, so I suspect that's the problem. Or is it a female? Sanura's the alpha. Yafoo! So who are you, my new one? Nuru, my dear? Off you pop. How are you still not in your ideal temperature? These blimmin' sheep, I swear. excuse me, folks. Bloody Nora. Where do I want to put the staff section? I kind of want to hide it over here, but our staff pathing is all over here, so let's stick over here for now. Let's get a wooden habitat gate. That looks fine. Lovely little bit of staff path. I know the game doesn't want you to do it, but I really don't mind having the staff pathing just sort of public a little bit. Yeah, I don't think that's the kind of thing you really have to hide in a real zoo, so I'm not going to hide it in my... Fake zoo. And we're not gonna. Oh my god. How has that happened? I thought it was fine. Was it not fine? It clearly wasn't fine. It looked okay a minute ago. I clearly don't know what I'm doing. Okay, so I need to start a new wall, essentially. I'd explain what I'm doing, but I feel like I do it in every single video. Because it is typically pretty necessary. It's got to be said. Oh. Oh.
Oh. Okay. Let me think. Game's yelling at me. Why don't we just make this into glass as well? Nice. Okay, that'll do. Yeah, whatever. That's nice. Okay, so. Wait, what? Now we need the actual barrier in. Eh? Nice. There we go. It all looks like it's all going terribly wrong, but it's totally okay. That is not determined. It's not like a big thing to worry about. Yeah, Lydia can't find a staff room. So what? She'll chill. Just slide down, have a nap, love. Don't have to make such a big deal about it. God. Kids these days, eh? Kids these days. Right, so what I want to do is get the wolves in. I should really send them to quarantine first. I acknowledge that. Just because I acknowledge it doesn't mean I'm going to do it. And let's cool things down again. We're just going to go slightly overboard just in case. This is tripping me out a little bit here, I'm not going to lie. Okay, the idea, of course, is I want this to be a snowy exhibit, just like our other one. There we go, looking good. Hopefully the wolves are okay with this. I think they should be. I've got to remember, put the roof down afterwards, best in slot. Put the blimmin' roof down afterwards. Also, that needs fixing. There's a little bit of a gap. There we go. It's just nice to have the tundra section. Tundra-y, you know? I think that makes sense. Keep it snowy. Keep it fresh. Nice. That's definitely not an... Oh, my God. What? What's going on over there? Oh, there we go. How happy are we with that? Yeah, no problems at all. Right, now. This is obviously not okay. What is going on? What? Okay. Half the exhibit is not usable. It's a big river. You know, the reindeer one's pretty chill. This one's huge. So we definitely need to make use of this land a little bit better. I think we're just going to use rocks. I'm pretty sure we're just going to use rocks. But we're going to try to make it look cool. I don't know what is going on over here. Have you just not cooled down enough yet? Oh, no. Ah! Okay. Cheeky. Well, now we can use wind turbines. So that's good. Just for now, that'll do. We good now? Yeah, I'm sure we'll be fine in a second. Okay, so let's go ahead and do these rocks. So we want nature, we want snee. There we go, snee. We're just gonna try to make it look as natural as possible. So, can't not say those words. So that it kind of looks like there's just this natural, oh my God, like rocky outcropping that happens to go across and creates a path. What we want to do is turn off the line to surface. That's gonna keep the rocks nice and flat, like so. I don't believe... We should also check they can't escape, but I am off the impression that wolves actually don't jump at all in this game. Like, they can't jump out of exhibits. I'm not 100% sure on that. This rock... Right, if we take this and then we flip it that way, that's pretty cool. That actually looks like an iceberg as well. I like that. That's awesome. Da-dum. Da-da-dum-dum. I don't know if this is going to look any good, but... Eh, what are you going to do? You must try. I love that noise. It's like one of those noises that I hate in real life, you know, because it sounds a little bit like polystyrene, which... Ugh, not a fan of the old polystyrene, tell you that much. But in-game, it's really satisfying for some reason. I've gone on about it before, but the sound design in this game is actually essentially impeccable. Now, bearing in mind, this side will become snowy at some point as well. Now, we're not done, I'm just saying, but the point is it should blend in a little bit better over there as well, especially if we just kind of snow rock up the side. I just want it to feel different than the one we've already got. You know, we've got this icy sort of one over here. This one is snow rocks. God knows why. Because why not? I always dreamt of being a snow rock. But Mama was like, no, son. You must become a professional YouTuber instead. Only then will your family be proud of you. It didn't work out as it happens, but hey-ho. I think this is actually going to look really cool. I do want to do more than just copy and paste the roof, however. I think because these two are sort of next to each other, we can kind of do that and it looks fine thematically. But I think for the next one, we'll have to do something a little bit different. I'd like to do something a little different. I still want to make an ice palace using the new tools we have, so I'm tempted by that. Alright, I just want to wait for this to come in. So, whilst we're doing that, let's grab some stuff for our wolvens. Arctic. Oh, they're at the bottom, aren't they? No. They're at the top. Am I blind? Am I actually blind? I am actually blind. Sweet. Stop inbreeding. All of you, desist. The inbreeding. It's totally my fault. I get that, but stop it. Just desist, please. There's no need for it. I've gone my whole life without inbreeding once. Like, what's your excuse? Oh, they're walking across. They're actually walking across. It looks like it's a snowy chasm. I want to actually thicken that up a bit, I think. Make this more impressive, because then it'll be like a snowy chasm that's kind of ripped through the exhibit. And they're just managing to cross over from one side to the other, which I think is pretty cool. How are we living? Are we good? Obviously any trees and stuff like that, but yeah, that's a 99%. Happy little doggo right there. Oh, oh, oh. You show that box who's boss. Who's boss? Your boss. Yeah. Aww. It's kind of adorable. It's genuinely kind of adorable. Okay, we're not done over here. Like I said, yeah, this is what we do. I want to make this a bit more impressive. Just big. Stop inbreeding! Like, I know you've got no one else to breed with, but, like, that's not an excuse. Again, no, be gone. People manage to not inbreed all the time. Even when there's no one else to breed with, people manage to avoid inbreeding. You don't have an excuse. Stupid bongos. I just want this to feel less like an individual collection of rocks and more like a thing, like a formation of some description. These ones are actually really good for it. Just don't want to go overboard with like the same type of rock just because that's obviously going to ruin the au naturel kind of appeal we're going for here. That's pretty cool. It reminds me a lot of, I watched a film fairly recently called Togo. Which is, right, for those who don't know, you know, right, people have heard of Balto, right? Who's the dog who's got, like, got the statue in New York City and, I believe in Central Park. Because they did this run where they saved all these kids by delivering this medicine to this, Alaskan town, right? I think it was Alaskan? I can't quite remember. And everyone's, like, always praising Balto, right? But, as it turns out, when you actually research it, or indeed watch this Disney film, Balto did like a very, very small part of the journey. Did the last part, so that's why it got, you know, made into a big thing. But overall, Balto was a small contributor to it. Did some heroic stuff, great dog, lovely dog, blah, 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 blah. But Togo did like most of the work, right? Togo basically saved the day completely. And so did Willem Dafoe, as it happens. And Togo therefore deserves more love. That's all I'm saying. Not that Balto was a bad dog. I think Balto's a lovely dog. But Togo did something like 8 times the distance of all the other dogs. It was like a 20 dog relay or something like that. And yet the only one they talk about is Balto. It's funny that. It's like little things about how history is just written in a certain way. And it doesn't really matter what's true. That's just what people remember, you know? It's kind of sad. Sure, the dogs don't care, but still, it's kind of sad. That's why you don't trust everything you read, essentially. This history is written by people who want it to be written that way. It's looking better. No, it doesn't. It's fine. Shut up. Nothing to worry about, seriously. People just panicking over nothing. No, it hasn't. Wait. To be fair, it could have. Is that okay? No, that's fine. Is that okay? I'm not sure that's okay, actually. It'll go back in, but I think that's not okay. I think we need to do something about that. I'm just gonna thicken up with rocks over on this side, because that's probably... Oh my god, these rocks are chunks. It's probably not a good thing. There we go, that should maybe stop it? Yeah, we'll see. Okay, good stuff. Right. Oh. that one is more of a problem. I'll acknowledge that much. That is a problem. I suspect they can just jump out the habitat, basically. Let's have a look. Yep. Not by much. It's only in this little bit down here. This is actually the only problem child I have. It seems to be they need, like maybe 1.2 meters or something like that. But I'm just going to bring that up. It's about there. And click them again. How are we doing? Yeah, sorted, am I right? Yeah, sweet, no problems. I said I was gonna check that, and then I completely forgot to check that. It really should be top priority, because it's a wolf. You can't really have it just bounding around the blimmin' exhibit, can you? Well, you can, but it's probably not a good idea. Land surface. No, it's not. Change that up and change that up. I'll use this again. We'll keep this on theme relatively. I want position snap on. I should just latch onto that like that. Lovely stuff. There we go. Come and learn all about the Arctic wolves. Have a lovely time. Right, we need some nature. It's not okay as is. And technically it's okay as is, but I don't think it's okay as is. Taiga and tundra. Now, this is the problem. There is not Arctic. It's not an option. So, the wolves are never going to be happy. Do you really? Right, let me play this. I mean, North America. Continent. North America. So why is it only... I'm just going to go take a tundra. North America. It should... I don't think it should be labeled as only Arctic. Arctic's not an option. I think this should be okay. Like, it's still limited, of course. That makes sense, but... It seems a little silly to me to not let me do anything. I really have to be careful with these trees, don't I? Yeah. Oh, that actually works, though. That's a cheeky little tree. Get these big ones in whilst I'm allowed. Squeeze one in that corner as well. Yep, and over there. Gotta make do where I can. Do I have any, like, little cute trees? Little babbies? Nope. Come on, give me a babby. Someone give me a babby. Why has no one given me a babby yet? If I put... Yeah, they're fine in the middle. I might have to stick to the... Yep. Yeah, we'll make it work. Just have to put it, like, the bits where it tilts up a little bit, and then maybe sink one or two down into the ground. I don't want to go too overboard with this, because at the end of the day, they're not... part of what the wolves actually want for whatever reason, so I think that'll do for trees. Yeah, that's a nice enough looking little shebang. Twin flowers, no. Labrador tea, yes. We'll do like a little decorative section up here at the top, I think. Amazing. A little bit over here as well. Okay, what else have we got? I unlimited a little... Oh, my beloved white sage. I do want to try to restrict myself just a little bit when it comes to this. I know I always say that. And I always do. And I always mean it at the time, even if it doesn't work out like that. But I am going to keep fairly chill here. As in, none of these rocks are going to have plants on them. Which is very upsetting for me, so can we all acknowledge my grand sacrifices going on right here? A little bit of white sage over here in the corner. Just in these areas over here at the sides, where the trees are thriving a little bit, is where the rest of the plants are thriving as well. It just happens to be the right growing conditions, and then it dies a little bit towards the middle. A couple trees make it, but by and large, it's definitely a much less foliage-rich zone. Any other bushes I like? I love a good bush, me. Cowberry, nope. Oh, yes, diamond leaf willow. Otherwise known as Bay. Otherwise known as the greatest thing in my life right now. Come on. Alright, you go there. I just love it. I just think that looks really cool. I cannot get over how much I like that. I'm going to put one in a gap in there, hopefully. They just look really good sticking out of rocks. I don't know why. But again, trying to keep it a little bit more chilled towards that section over there. Yeah, I think that'll do. It's quite nice looking. From up here, it kind of blends in. Yeah. I mean, blending in is a push. But I'd say the actual building work and stuff like that looks like it fits within the park. Even like that. We've got this on this like lower level one over here. It kind of looks like it's undulating downwards a little bit, which I think is pretty cool. Oh yeah, where's that gap? There it is. Oh right, for some reason that one hasn't moved down. I think that's actually the problem. There we go. Okay. I'm pretty happy. Well, I mean, in game, let's not go there in real life, but. No, yeah, pretty happy with how this has turned out. I think the wolves are pretty happy. They can get across. That is looking kind of what I'd want it to, quite natural, that bridge in the middle. So, all we really need to do is make the whole thing a little bit more appropriate for, well, what we're doing. So, what we want is biome desert. And we're just going to screw around some plants. Some proteas as per usual. Just good to. I kind of want to hide the snow a little bit. We'll probably have to go back in with the brush tool anyway and clean that up a little bit. Do for now. Doesn't matter that they're slightly inside it. That's fine. That's fun for the whole family. Is that going to look weird? Yeah, no, that's fine. Can we maybe sand this up a teeny bit if we just go really small brush and just want to get a slightly bigger brush than that because that's not doing a blimmin' thing. Oh, that's too many blimmin' things. Two, we're looking for a two. There we go. Oh, that'll be beautiful. Just want to get around the edges there a little bit. There we go. Okay. Everything feels pretty good. Not sure what to do over here. Not sure what to do with any of this bit over here, because I don't really want. We could put an exhibit there, to be fair. We could put the polar bears there. It wouldn't be that big a deal. It's a little bit of a stretch from the staff facility, but we could then block off this right-hand side completely. Just have this wall, essentially. Block that whole area off, and then you walk down here, and you do feel like you're in a tundra zone. You look to the right, and tell you what, let's make this into glass as well. You walk to the right, you see the reindeer, look to the left, you see the wolves, you go over the bridge that's covered in snow and ice and all this good stuff. Very thematically cool. If we just add a little bit of detail onto that. Walk over the bridge, more plants and stuff, and then bam, polar bear exhibit in this big open space at the far end. I like that idea. That's what we'll do. And it keeps the tundra walk as kind of like a little bit of a walk, you know, it's its own contained thing, and we could even loop this back in over here, like that, right? And then we could have another tundra zone entrance over on this side. Maybe you pay extra. You're not actually going to pay extra, but maybe we could have like a little ticket booth where you can pay to get into the tundra zone. It's like a little bonus. Kind of like when you go to a zoo and they want you to pay extra to go to the aquarium and stuff like that. I don't think many of them do that, but some definitely do, so that's my justification. Anyways, let's get some stuff in here. I really actually really love this really strong juxtaposition between the desert look of the outside of these exhibits and then inside where you've got this, obviously, this big tundra snow effect. I don't know if from above it looks great, but I think when you get down here towards it, it ends up looking really cool. I mean, that looks great to me, with the snow and the desert. Big fan. Humongous chungus. Sorry, my nose is itchy. I have to talk nonsense for a second as I fix my face. Some things can't be fixed. organ pipe can... Then another little... Ooh, he's a big boy. There we go. Get some little desert rocks in there. Really just trying to make the whole thing just link in together with the others and, I don't know, just look cool. Simple as that. Just want it to look cool. Kind of trying to stick to the same rough stuff every time. I don't want to mix it up too much. Oh, I really like that, actually. I'll put that there. Just, maybe we're not going to put a wall here. We'll see. But just something to block off this side a little bit is a good idea. I don't really want people looking over here. This shouldn't be important. My face is so itchy. You know what I mean? So just some desert stuff. Maybe some big rocks in front of there. That's a good idea as well, actually. Maybe some big boulders. Now, coincidentally, as happens, you know, you put all this stuff in, you put these big rocks in, put these huge boulders in, and that's probably going to attract attention, which is the opposite of what I'm going for. But at least it makes the whole thing blend a little bit more into the surrounding environment. Yeah? Yeah. Am I happy with this? I think we might be nearly done, folks. It's a great... Yeah, I love these. Some of those in there. Yeah, no, just again trying to sell that idea a little bit that there's a world beyond, you know, that we're not going to be privy to. It's just you accept that that's like the natural environment beyond the realms of the zoo. Some rubbish like that. Nearly done. A couple of aloe veras dotted around in these little gaps by the rocks in particular. So many people are going to get ripped to shreds by cacti. They really are. Right, I'm going to say that is pretty good. Pretty done. Pretty happy with that. The wolves are happy, seemingly. Right? What is that? Is that feces? So happy that they're feceing everywhere, which is an official term. We're happy? 92%, not bad. Nutrition could be a bit higher. Social space, really? Huh. Surprises me. One good thing about this is it provides shelter. I don't need to actually put a shelter in it. It counts already. Oh, we need donation bins. That's what we need. Do I have any over here? No, that's immensely silly. Okay, cool. Not a bomb. I might actually make them blue. A, I can be lazy, but B, it fits that tundra theme just a little bit more. Over lazy. Oh, he's on the move, isn't he? All right, buddy, what are you doing? Ah, he's grabbing the wolf. Right, that makes sense. There we go. There's our little wolf habitat. Arctic wolves. We can maybe get a few more of them. We only have a few. Can we grab a couple? You want to be good to me, game? Right, it's not there, right? I'm not going crazy. It's at the bottom, right? Yeah, okay. On some lists, it's at the bottom. On some lists, it's not at the bottom. It's a little bit weird, but that's fine. Grab those. Send to zoo. Lovely stuff. Oh, no. Ah, right. I think this actually might be a water treatment problem. This was always going to be a problem. This right here. Because I can't connect this with anything else. So, in this case, what we do is delete it. And add another one. And problem solved. I don't know why they're all failing all around the park, but there you go. Let's get mechanics on both of those. Might hire another one. We do have a little bit of cash to hand right now, so I'm not that worried about it. Boop. Everyone okay over here? Yeah, usual stuff, not a problem. I think this Arctic section has really cut the tundra zone. It's looking pretty cool. Look at that. Isn't that nice? Yeah. It does lack for lighting, I'll say that much. It does need lights. But other than that, I think we're good. I do think I'm going to move the reindeer. I don't really want to put another exhibit in here. I kind of like the idea I've got going now, so I really just want to do the polar bear there. So I think we move the reindeer over there. We put something there, probably a grizzly bears or something like that. And then we get the polar bear in there and... good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff. Sorry. yeah, right. So, let's spend a little time with our wolf. Aww. I like that they're using this as well. Like, and it looks kind of natural. I think this left side is a little bit heavier than the right side. Let's get you some food, shall we? It's actually... The food is actually the problem right now, as it happens. The keeper's there, though. That's okay. Got our new Arctic wolves. Amka has arrived in the zoo. There she is, looking beautiful. What are you up to, Amka? Aww. Why are you in the shade? If you weren't in the shade, this would be such a perfect thumbnail. It really would. She's so cute. That is adorable. It really... look at her. Oh, they are struggling a little bit. You can see them bouncing around all over the place. But by and large, you know, they're crossing over both sides without a problem. I wonder if my keeper can cross. That would be the next question. Also, I kind of want to put this on there. Yeah, cool. We happy? We're happy. I'm happy. Alright, I have to go. I'm off to the cinema today and I must prepare myself and such. And my face is still itchy. Yeah, pretty happy with this. So, I mean, this whole thing, whole shebang is taking a little bit longer than I... wait, seriously? Maybe anticipated. But silver will be finished next video, because we're just going to move it across. And then we're just adding polar bears. So next video will actually be the final video, I believe. Pretty sure there's food in the exhibit. Will be, I believe, the final video. Ah, that might be why, actually. I'm just going to put another one in. Will be the final video for Arctic Park. We've put more work in, we've put the effort in. You know, we've got some really nice looking exhibits over here, and... well, that's not mine, but this one over here is a little beauty with a doll sheep. And our Arctic zone definitely took longer than I usually would have spent on it, but... well, tundra zone, I should say. But it looks pretty cool, so I'm happy. Right, I will end before I talk for many moons. Thank you so much for joining me. Like I say, we will finish this off in the next video where we'll be adding the polar bears into the Mexican desert. That sounds like it could only go really, really well. Until then, thank you for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.